Kenny Trout is a billionaire worth $1.2 billion who made his fortune when he founded Excel Communications back in the late 80s during telecoms deregulation. And what his company did was resold access to networks with a Mary Kay style sales staff that sold to friends and family. Trout grew up poor in the housing projects in Mount Vernon, Illinois. Working off of some inspiration from his own mother, who made him play sports he wasn't any good at, Kenny Trout founded the Texas Titans to keep his two kids, Preston and Grant, out of trouble. His mother always told him that sports taught you a lot of things about life, how to work hard, how to play fair with others, and it kept him out of trouble, and he feels it'll keep his kids out of trouble too. So he went and created an entire team that included building an entire full-sized basketball court attached to his mansion, spending $3 million a year traveling via plane, staying in hotels, and coaching for a youth basketball team that has become one of the most elite youth basketball teams in the country. So there's three Titans age groups, and the eldest, the one that just graduated this year in 2013, has fared very well. They have some of the best players in that age bracket in the whole country. While I was down in Dallas, Texas, I talked with both Julius Randle and Matt Jones, the two star players to come out of the Titans. Julius Randle is largely considered his graduating class's best power forward. He was ranked number three on ESPN's top 100 amateur basketball players, and he'll be moving on to play for Kentucky. Matt Jones, ranked 36th on that same ESPN list, will be going to play for Duke. The three teams collectively have won three AAU championships over the course of the about 7 years that they've been playing. So not a bad record. Trout's a born-again Christian, and one of his pet projects for the Titans is to give his players all of the resources he wishes he had as a kid. So in part that means the team is very religious. There's prayers, or what they call devotionals, before and after games and practice. They bring in religious speakers, speakers on what they call sexual purity, personal finance speakers, and the idea is to give them a holistic education that will be worthwhile to them even after they leave the Titans. Reception to the Texas Titans has been mixed. On one hand, you see these really poor kids who are really good at basketball getting all the resources they need to succeed at basketball. On the other hand, spending this sort of money in a amateur league is deemed unfair by a lot of people in that league. Nobody else's budget comes anywhere close to the size of the Titans' budget. You get the impression from other teams that they think that the Titans might be spoiled, or that they are simply over-resourcing. They're spending more money than they need to. One of the most interesting things about the Titans is Trout doesn't treat them as a philanthropy. He only has three teams. Those are the only three teams they have currently. It's the only teams they plan on creating, and he has no plans for future teams. It begins and ends with his own kids' age groups. It is, so far as my reporting has shown, a totally different way of a billionaire spending his money. He doesn't consider it philanthropy. It's definitely selfishly driven, but it still manages to help people in the process. And normally you think of those as two totally discrete entities, either something you're doing for pleasure, collecting art, collecting other things, sending your kids to great schools, or you're investing in philanthropy. And this is a case of accidental philanthropy, unlike anything I've ever seen before.